you guys. Welcome back. This is my second attempt recording this intro because I was wearing pajamas and you could definitely see that I was wearing pajamas. So now I'm in pants and I look like I have my life together. Anyways, for those of you that don't know, I'm a fly fishing guide at Pyramid Lake and I make these videos. But I have been running into quite a few people at the lake that have been watching the videos, and I figured, why would I not at least put together a little series of like some of the patterns that are staples for me that I have my clients use and flies that I've been fishing out here for a very long time. So today we're gonna be tying a stripping pattern. This is a tadpole slash beetle. Beetle is the smaller, or is the tailless version of the tadpole. Tadpole has a tail. They take this as a bunch of different things. There's dragonfly nymphs in the lake. There are actually aquatic beetles that live in the lake that when they are hatching, they get a methane bubble underneath their wing case and it pulls them to the surface and then they try and swim down. So every time you strip, you fish a sinking line with a floating fly. So when you strip it, it actually swims down and it looks just like those beetles. But realistically, they could take it as a minnow, they could take it as a leech, they could take it as just about anything that swims. But all I know is it catches a bunch of fish. And yeah, so we're gonna tie just the tadpole because the beetle is essentially the tadpole without a tail. This is the original pattern, not this. But yeah, so we're gonna get started. But also, we have the Balanced Diet shirts back, which are easily the sickest fly fishing related shirt on the market. Just a balanced leech, and then a big trout coming to eat it. But there'll be a link for these in the description. I appreciate everybody that's already purchased one. I've actually sold quite a few of them. So I'm stoked on it, and I appreciate all you guys. But let's get tied to this pattern. Okay, so this is the finished product. You'll see pretty quickly that this is not a very complex fly. But the hook that we're tying this on is actually a Daiichi Stinger hook. Every fly at Pyramid needs to be barbless. So we'll crimp that barb with the vise. Looks good. So this is a Daiichi Stinger hook. I like to tie this when I'm tying them in black, but if I'm tying them in like this olive or the traditional, I'll use a regular Stinger hook that just doesn't have the same color. I just like the red hook with the red. I think it looks dope. And it catches fish, so that's all you can ask for, right? But anyways, we're gonna wanna make sure we lay down a really good thread base on this pattern. Really tight thread base, I should say. Just because of the fact that we're tying foam, and foam has a tendency to spin on you. So we'll put down a decent little thread base there. Come back over here, go to the tail. And we're just using, this is just a woolly bugger length marabou. You can buy them in like strung packs. So you're just gonna take, you want it to be kind of long, about the length of the body, just so that it has like optimum swimming capabilities. So we're gonna tie this in, and you know, this can be kind of ugly when you tie this in because you're about to wrap a bunch of stuff on it. So, okay, then we're gonna take this is a 3mm black foam. It's just like a craft foam, it's nothing fancy. Here's the actual package so you can see what it's called, but this is in olive. So it's 3mm in black. And for this pattern, I like to cut it pretty wide. So you'll see right here when I give this, it's about a half inch in width, which is pretty big, I would say, in comparison to most. But when I'm stripping these, it's usually early in the morning or in the evenings or in bad weather, and I like to have a bigger bug that's seen easier. So I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna wrap this foam in, and as I'm wrapping this, I'm kinda just folding it over itself to the side so I get the thread wraps there. Perfect. I like that. Okay. Now it's gonna hang down. I'm gonna take some red chenille. This is a medium-sized chenille. It's not the large one is a little long. I like that for bait fish colors, but for the black and red or the more beetle colors, I like to stick with this. So I'm gonna come back here and I'm gonna tie this in at the very back. I'm gonna wrap this back like so. Okay, wrap back up. And with each of these wraps, I'm going to palmer this. So I'm gonna go one wrap
And then I'm going to pull these fibers back. Pull these fibers back. And this way I'm not trapping any fibers and it gets as full of a body as I want on it because it's not super long. So I like to have quite a bit of it. Okay. So there's that right there. I'm going to tie that off just to make sure. There we go. And the nice thing about this upward shaped eye is it actually helps the bug swim a little bit different in the water than I think most of them do. So I'm going to take this foam, my tag, and I'm going to fold it over the top. And I like to kind of split this so that I don't trap any fibers. Like so. Pull it forward. And I'm going to use that pressure with my thumb on the top. And when it folds up, that's how you know you did it right. Because you want a little bit of a tag right here. A little whip finish. Like so. I'm going to cut this. And then, when I cut this tag end, I'm going to line it just about where the hook eye is at, a little bit further. Because I want a little tiny thing here. And that actually helps that fly kind of shuffle in the water and swim a little bit more like a fish. But then you got this little tag here that you can tie right into. And that is the fly. Very simple, super effective bass fly. And if you want to fish it on a floating line, it's a great little topwater pattern. It's basically a miniature gurgler. But yeah, and then you can tie these in all other colors too. But they crush for trout at Pyramid. And I've fished them at quite a few other lakes that have the same sandy bottom and done very well on them as well. So whatever they're eating them as, they like to eat them. Yeah, and that's the fly. Like I said, not a complex fly, pretty simple bug, super effective, catches a lot of fish, and you want to tie it with a good heavy wire hook because the fish at Pyramid are very big, and a lot of times when they eat it, you're strip setting into those, and that initial strip set can bend out hooks that don't have the right wire strength. So, yeah, but that's the pattern. Like I said, I'm going to link in the description below my website, my guiding stuff that I have. If you want to follow Fly Dudes Guiding on Instagram, that's where I post all the pictures of fish the clients are catching. And we had a really good start to the season, and it's just going to get better and better as the season goes on. But I appreciate all you guys watching. Tie up a bunch of these in a bunch of different colors, especially if you love catching trout on the strip, because this is, you know, you can have all kinds of flies for Pyramid Lake, but this is really the only one you need to strip with, because if you have this in a couple different colors, you'll catch fish on it very, very well. So, but yeah, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys next week.